Hi, friends. Hi. How are you? It's Sarah Potenza, OBS, because you're on my page. And we're doing this live thing. Ian, will you do me a favor and just check my Sarah Potenza page and make sure we're good?
Facebook.
Yes, please. So I have a new program. It's called eCam. It's really cool. It's a live program that I'm using. And it's just it's brand new. And I'm super excited to get to use this program. It's a new computer program that I get to use. And I'm bringing you all the Christmas glamour. Oh, all the Christmas glamour that you could ask for. I love it. I love the Christmas glam. Oh my goodness. So anyways, what have you guys been up to? Tell me about your Christmases. Are you guys gonna be baking this year? I feel like we all really learned how to bake, like a lot. I did a lot of baking this year. It was really fun. Not just weed, but you know, like the baking, the actual breads and such. What was my favorite thing that I made this year? I made these pistachio cookies. So one of my favorite things, hi Susan! This is so cool. Hold on, I can click to view. Oh, look at the comments. Oh, this is so cool, okay. This is new to me, this program, this eCam, and now I have a little sidebar of the comments. Hi, Jim, how are you? Great to see you too, babe. So exciting.
How's it looking?
It looks great. Everything looks so good. I'm so excited to sing for people. So yeah, I made a lot of baking, I love Italian Christmas cookies. You know the ones that have like the, it looks good, babe? Awesome. You know the ones that have like the little white icing with the little colorful sprinkles, like the little teeny little sprinkles? I love those. My dad always used to make those. And also I just always had those, like when I was a kid at the house for Christmas, they were like a thing. So anyways, I was really excited to possibly make some of those. And my grandmother on my mom's side, my British grandma, she used to make these things called maids, and they were like a layer of pastry tart, kind of a pastry, like a pie crust almost, and then a layer of raspberry filling, and then a layer of vanilla cake topped with like an icing that almost like formed a crust in a way. What do you call that kind of icing?
Which one?
It's not royal icing. It kind of is, like on top of my Nana's maids. It wasn't buttercream. Anyway,
it was
really good. And she was a glaze, and I inherited the tins to make this really good cookie, and so I'm excited that I will get to be making those. So I'm gonna make some Christmas stuff. So I don't know what you guys are making, but my P.O. box is 68322 Nashville, Tennessee, 37206. So please send over whatever you're making. I want some. It's all about the errand, you're right. It is all about the shortbreads, girl. Ooh, I love shortbreads. So I made these pistachio shortbreads this year. Those were so good. They were really, really good. You know who has the best recipes? King Arthur, the flour company. If you go online, they have really good recipes. I swear to you, their carrot cake recipe is amazing. Anyways, I keep looking down because my camera's here and then my monitor's here so I can see all of your lovely comments. Thank you, Angela. I feel good. I'm looking glittery and pretty. I am really actually feeling really excited to celebrate Christmas this year. Not that I have had the most wonderful year as we all have now, but you know what? The celebrating is gonna be good. And I learned a lot this year. More to come on that for a New Year's perhaps, but anyways, I just wanted to give you guys a little time. Thank you, Joel, I feel really good. Give you guys a little time to pop on and get me up on your screens or whatever, however you want to listen to the concert. And yeah, let me rock this concert for you all. Okay, here we go. Let's try it. Let's try a song. I'm going to try a song. This is a really cool program. Are you excited? Check this out. So this is Christmas. And what have you done? Another year over, and a new one's just begun. See all of your comments tonight. This is so cool. I hope you all enjoyed this song. I am doing this a little differently tonight, but I am going to do some of it the way that I used to do it, where I will have Ian come and play a little bit of music, and I would like him to come play some music now, actually. When I think about Christmas songs, I always think about this song because I was born in 1980, so I grew up in the 90s, you know, and this was like the ultimate Christmas song of Christmas songs. It's kind of actually, to me, really one of the only new Christmas songs out there. I mean, it's not new now, but it was new at the time that I would say, oh wow, that's a classic, you know? That became a classic. I think Christmas songs are probably pretty hard to write.
They all seem like they're silly.
They do seem silly. But you know what? This one's silly in the best possible way. It really is. Anyways, let's give it a try.
I don't want a lot for Christmas. There is just one thing I need. I don't care about cause I just want you for my own, more than you will ever know. Make my wish come true, baby. Oh, I want, all I want for Christmas. You
Song to pull off on an acoustic, but you know what? The track was fun, but it wasn't giving me anything different. And I said, let's just give them that Sarah Pretends That They Love, you know? Playing the guitar and singing a little bit. For some of it anyways, but I hope you all like that song. Oh, I see the claps coming in, and oh my God, thank you so much, Joel, thank you. That's one of my favorites. That is, I got a lot of chords in it. It's not the easiest song, but I really, really love that one. I do. I wasn't kidding about the cookies. Now, I did already receive some cookies from one of my friends, Maureen. She's an incredible baker. She sent a box that had some really great breads in it, including a gingerbread. And that was pretty good. So you'll need to step it up and send some cookies. Please, send chocolates, send cookies. What'd you say?
And a PlayStation.
Oh, and Ian wants you to send him a PlayStation 5. Because we are unemployed, so he cannot buy one. But he wants one. But I don't think Santa's gonna get him that this year. But we'll see what happens in 2021, you know? Speaking of which, I did put my tip jar up there, my PayPal and my Venmo. Please do not feel obligated. I know times are really tough right now. If you would like to send us a Christmas gift, we will graciously accept. If you would like to tip, you can. But I really want to stress that I didn't put it up there to stress anybody out. I know how hard it is right now. Believe me, I know. I just really wanted to sing you all some of my favorite songs. I hope that you're enjoying them. This is one of my most favorite Christmas songs.
Bells will be ringing.
My mother is on here and she wants me to come home for Christmas, but it is not safe this year, Mom. I can't do it. I'm sorry. I have to be very careful, and we all have to be real careful this year. It is not going to be the most But I'm trying to make the holidays fun by bringing some people some fun and some joy with these Christmas songs. So just enjoy it, because it's all we got. We had a really good time the other night. I'm not sure if you guys caught the One Mic Christmas program or not, but it was so much fun. And that is actually available to you in a YouTube link, which I posted on my page if you'd like to watch it. It's also a free show. It was benefiting Music Cares, the donations. They've been an incredible organization, so shout out to them. They have literally paid for my bottom teeth, so I have a pole piece that's the bottom. It's not removable or anything. It's just very expensive. And they paid for that for me. They've been just incredible. So anyways, so shout out to them and check out that program. Anyway, this next tune, it's one of my faves. It's called White Christmas. And I love this song. I remember this Christmas in the 90s. I think it was 1994, and it was just a nonstop snow. It was so beautiful and so much fun. And I remember just like no school constantly. I lived in Smithfield, Rhode Island, and it was always no school Smithfield. And I would just like go out and go sledding and stuff with my friends. And I love snow and I miss it. Here in Nashville, I actually remember when I was a kid, we used to get a sled every year from a store named Benny's. We were allowed to get one sled. We could go with my dad. And I loved Benny's because they had a bin of candy bars that were 3 for $1. And I always was allowed to get some. Oh, boy, you can really hear everything in that microphone. I like heard myself drinking. Anyway, so you have 2 feet of snow right now. Hi, Smithfield. Hi. My friend Joel in New York. You're in New York, right, Joel? Upper, but a little bit upper state. See, Cheryl Rowling, I'm staying safe. I'm staying home. I'm going to stay safe. And I'm going to keep my family safe. And, you know, it is what it is, but we're going to get through this, guys. And it's going to be, we're going to be stronger and better. Honestly, I learned so much this year. I learned how to do this whole program. This is a program called ECAM, and they hooked me up with this program. And I learned how to use this, and I'm able to, like, use my microphone. And I think the sound is really good, right? The sound is good, and the picture's good, and it's a whole thing. Hi, Rhode Island. I love Rhode Island. I miss the pizza strips. Anyway, so I love this tune. It's one of my faves. Let's get it.
Like the world.
Did you like it? Isn't that a great track? That's an Otis Redding track. So I went through and found like the tracks that I wanted. And I did them. Oh, thank you, Kitty. I really appreciate you. I did them all through this. I put them through GarageBand and put them the way I wanted and fixed them all up for you all. And I just love that track. I tried to find the bluesy ones, you know, because I like the blues. My mom raised me to listen to a lot of that music when I was a kid. Hi, Mary Fry. Hi. And we listened to a lot of blues music. And I remember as a kid, the Christmas album that was always on at my house was Aaron Neville's Christmas. And so I listened to that a lot around Christmas time. And I actually pulled one of his tracks for this next tune. I liked it so much. I just remember loving it, and I was like, let me just pull this one. So the track turned out great, and here it is. This is one of my Christmas faves.
Stars are brightly shining. It is the night of my dear Savior's birth. Long lay this old world in sin and error. Justice reign, and all of this hatred be gone. And yes, I hold out this hope for my sisters and my brothers. The darkest hour may it be just before. A new glorious morn.
Man, it sure is weird to finish a song like that and not hear the clapping. But I see it on the screen. Thank you so much. I'm so glad you all are enjoying the show. I'm so glad. I would not be able to do a show without Ian at least ripping one guitar solo. Ian, why don't you come say hello to everyone when you get a sec? Anyways, so hopefully we'll get to see you in 2021. But until then, I'm going to be doing these great concerts. They helped us to make a living, and they helped me mentally because I need to sing. So anyway, here's Ian. Come say hi to everybody. Sneak in here. Pop down, up. Don't be creepy, though.
I'm trying to be creepy, but because I looked there.
Yeah, it's
there.
Here. You say hi to everybody.
Hi, everybody.
Ian's still here with no beard. He hates it, but yeah. It keeps him safe. I know, he's a fashion icon. No, you were talking about me, Joel. Me! Anyways, so, Ian, will you rip a song with us?
Rip a song.
On guitar.
Yeah.
I want to do just one where you rip a little. It wouldn't be a show without Ian ripping a guitar solo, right? Come on now. I'm going to play one more on guitar for you all. I'm going to wow you. Oh! I think I dropped my pick. Do you have a gray one I can borrow? If you don't, there's tons in my room.
No, I can get one.
Oh, no, it's right here. It was in my guitar. I'm always losing these things, guys. I lose them like hair elastics. I just constantly lose them. Anyways, I could not go without ripping this one, so. I'm gonna, oh, no, you're fine. I just have to unmute you.
Unmute me.
Okay. See, I unmuted you, so don't be too loud. I don't know if you changed your volume. You're good?
I feel like I'm good.
We're gonna bring it for the people?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. I remember the intro, too.
Yeah.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
He can take.
Hey, thanks for joining me, babe.
Woo!
Thank you for coming to be a part of my concert. I appreciate you. I do. I love Christmas music. Ian doesn't love it as much as me. So I had to convince him to come play a few songs with me. But he was like, I'll do it. I'll do it for the people. Thank you all so much. Thank you so much. Oh, I'm going to play this next one on guitar. And I'm going to play by myself because you know what? This is a lullaby, as I was told. Yeah, I got this. Okay, this is a lullaby, so. Anyway, my mom loves this one. When I was a kid, we used to go to church with my grandma every Christmas Eve, and it would be the midnight mass, Episcopalian church in Centerdale, Rhode Island, and they would pass the candles along, and we would light the candles and sing Silent Night. And one year, my little cousin was holding one of the candles, and he kind of let it lean, and the wax dripped onto his hand, and he screamed in the middle of this song. I also have another really good Christmas Eve story for you guys. We were invited to go to a Christmas Mass, a big Catholic Christmas Mass, because where I come from, there's a lot of Roman Catholics because it's very Italian. And the bishop came to that Mass. And I don't remember this, but my older brother swears that when I saw the bishop, I thought that it was Jesus or God. And I started screaming, "Oh my God is here! Jesus is here! He came! He's here!" And my brother like put his hand over my mouth to shut me up, and I kept biting him. Anyway, I love this tune. It's such a beautiful lullaby, and it's a song that always makes me think of my Nana around Christmas time.
Ah.
thank you all so much. It's hard for me to sing a lullaby, you know? My voice is kind of like a big dump truck. But in a good way, in a good way, you know? But I'm not a lullaby girl. So this next song took me a couple of weeks to properly learn. I wanted to do it for this One Mic Christmas show, and it was one of my favorite songs, and it's not a Christmas song, but it kind of is. And it was on CeeLo Green's Christmas album, and I love this song, and I thought, why not, you know? I did not realize what I was getting myself into, because this is actually a very difficult song. Joni Mitchell's voice, she's a beautiful songbird, and she can go anywhere she wants to go, and her voice is very narrow in a way. And that makes the sound very pliable, very agile, very quick to move, almost like she's like a cat, you know? Like an outdoor cat. And I'm like an indoor cat with my voice. So my voice is kind of thick. So it's a lot harder to get it to move the way that she gets her voice to move. But I love this song so much that I had to do it. So I'm going to sing it for you guys here. Don't you love this program, the eCam with the tracks? Aren't you enjoying it? Let me know what you think, and if you're enjoying the show, and if you can and you want to, please leave us a tip. My PayPal and my Venmo are there, and we would really, really appreciate that tonight. And if you cannot leave us a tip, we are just so glad you're here at the show. We're glad you're healthy and safe, and please do not feel like you have to in any way. Okay, yeah, let's do this. Thank you. Oh my God, I love that song so much. Oh, I love that song. Thank you, Joel. It's flawless because I put the work in. Let me tell y'all something about my job. If you show up and you give 200% of yourself all the time, opportunities will happen for you and you never, ever know. Who's watching? You never know who's watching this tonight. You never know what can happen, and I just love to show up and put the work in. So I was really looking forward to tonight's concert because it was a lot of work to get the songs together, to make sure they were all in the right key and they had the right arrangement and they sounded right and this mix sounded good and this Ecamm thing. And I really, really enjoy my work. I love my work. I'm a perfectionist. I love when a song is just delicious. So thank you so much. I wanna thank you all for being here. I'm gonna close out the night. I have one more song for you all. I hope that you guys have just a really wonderful holiday. I know it's been a tough year, but remember to celebrate. Remember to celebrate, honestly, because it's really been, it's been very meaningful for me to get to just celebrate Christmas, the simplicity of it. It's really nice to have something to look forward to, you know? If you would like to, once again, please hit up our PayPal or our Venmo or our P.O. Box. Some cookies or whatever you are welcome to, and you are welcome also to just enjoy the free concert tonight. I wanted you to have a concert, a Christmas concert, and for me, this was a gift to me to get to sing these songs for you because I love this music so much. And I got to use these cool lights and this program, and I just had such a great time tonight. Like reading your comments, all the familiar faces, so awesome. So thank you all so much for everything you've done for me this year. Your support, your tips, your love, people who've been sending letters and sending gifts and sending money and sending just their love and support to us. I just want you to know how much of a lifeline that has been to me, to know that I'm loved and that what I do matters, because we do feel like dinosaurs right now in the live music industry. So thank you. I hope y'all have a wonderful holiday. I love you all so much. Thank you so much. I know you know this, and you all know you want to sing along. So feel free to go ahead, because I can't hear you. Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light. We'll be near to us once more. you so, so much for joining us. I can't wait to read all your comments.